Capricorn, welcome to your weekly reading. This is going to be for the sign of Capricorn. It's not going to resonate with all of you out there. This is also not Sun, Moon, or Venus sign specific. Any Capricorn placement you deem worthy, messages may also resonate. At the end, we'll pull some oracles, give you a little bit more guidance for the week. Personal reading information, any jewelry seen will all be linked and listed. Jumping right in, Capricorn, Eight of Wands was your first card out. Followed by the Sun card, Major Arcana for Leo energy. We also have the Three of Swords. We also have Major Arcana, the Tower. Scorpio energy could be important to you. Some sort of shocking news. There could be some sort of communication that is either given to you or from you, by you, I should say, that is going to be very shocking. For some of you, it's a pregnancy. Some of you, not all of you. For some of you, it's a pregnancy that's going to shock people. Whether it's your pregnancy, someone else's pregnancy, that's going to shock you. The Sun card here, Leo energy. We just entered Leo season, so this could be happening now. Something that's maybe been taking a while for those of you that have been trying. There could also be, I'm very much getting this as communication. Something is being said, something is being spoken that is going to be very shocking. For some of you, it's a new job. Some sort of new position, new stream of income. And for some of you, whatever this is, it's going to be shocking. It is something that has been taking a very long time to sort of achieve. Or you've been keeping it quiet for a while and now you're finally ready to sort of let it out. The Sun card is the happiest card in the deck though. So whatever it is that has been taking a long time that is finally getting ready to move forward, it is something that is absolutely going to elevate you, your happiness, your joy. Nothing happier than a baby and a pony. Could also be some sort of creative endeavor. We also have the Three of Swords here though. So there's something that you have been trying to create. It also could be that something is coming to light that may hurt some of you or hurt other people. Shocking, and it may hurt some people. One more card, please. We have the King of Wands, Queen of Wands. Fire sign energy, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius with the Two of Cups at the bottom of the deck. Yeah, some of you, this is some sort of relationship that you are finally coming public with. Relationship, partnership, whichever it is, you and someone else that are on the same page, you have the same goal, same amount of interest in whatever it is, whether it's each other, a job, a business, a plan. Some of you might be getting eloped too, surprising, and it might elope and surprise some people and hurt some people as well in the process. But the Queen of Wands, she doesn't really care who she hurts. She's very much about what makes her happy. And the Queen of Wands is also creation energy. So for some of you, you're absolutely creating life itself, but there is some sort of bond, a tie that you are also creating that I do think you're either becoming public with, moving forward with. But it is going to hurt some people, shock some people. Knight of Wands, Sagittarius energy, and the Ace of Pentacles. For some of you, it is a new job. It also is some sort of engagement or proposal. And we also have the Empress here. And for some of you, it absolutely is a pregnancy. Some of you are also just becoming a spouse. But with the Empress here, the Queen of Wands, the Two of Cups, and the Sun card, for some of you, it's definitely a human being that you are creating with someone, and it is going to shock people. Especially those of you that already have children. That could be where this Three of Swords is coming from. This could be some sort of new partner that you are expanding with, creating life with, creating a family with. Someone that makes you very happy, though. But it does seem like it's going to maybe piss some people off a little bit. We also have the Knight of Wands here, Sagittarius, more Sagittarius energy. Not more Sagittarius energy, but Sagittarius energy. Some of you are getting on a new adventure. You're either starting a new relationship, a new career. Some of you might need to move for this new career if this is job related. That could also be why it might hurt some people, but you got to do what's best for you. You got to do what's best for you, yeah. Justice system. Definitely could be a marriage in the cards. No pun intended for some of you. The Two of Wands, something you've been indecisive about whether you should do or not, but got to do what makes you happy. We don't live for anyone but ourselves. Let it shock who it shocks. Let it hurt who it hurts. But there's someone here that you are connecting with very strongly on a mutual level. And there's lots of opportunity if you do choose to move forward. And I think you're going to move forward. This Knight of Wands is suggesting to me that you are taking this opportunity. You are seeing this as the gift that it is. And you're very excited about it. Very happy. It makes you very happy. We have here, show the world the real you. Yep. Mm-hmm. Full moon in Aquarius. A lot of you have been hiding this relationship, hiding this pregnancy, hiding this job, moving, this move you're about to make, because you do know it's going to hurt some people. But you're going to do it anyway. It's time to be authentic. It's time to live out loud. Show the world the real you. We also have the answers you need are coming. Full moon in Gemini, so there's definitely a talk that needs to be had. For those where this is love, there's definitely a talk that needs to be had. An announcement I'm getting. Took you a long time to come out with it, but now you've been keeping it secret probably for a while, or just keeping it to yourself for a while, but now it's saying it's only a matter of time before you're going to have to express this. Some of you could be moving for a job for sure. Deception. Someone is wearing a false mask in this relationship. There's definitely, I'm getting that vibe that they're, you've been hiding something. I don't think it's bad though. I think you've just been worried because you know it's going to hurt some people. Some people will not agree with your decisions. But I think you're going to do it anyways because it does make you happy. The Sun card here, lots of potential. Whatever this is mutual, yeah, engagement, see? Your love life is ascending to a higher level of commitment. For some of you, you are eloping. For some of you, you secretly have been engaged or you're getting engaged and you've been hiding it for a while. For some of you, you're expecting. Okay. What else do we need? Let's get one of these. Capricorn. Something's going on and you don't want people to know about it yet, or you haven't wanted people to know about it yet. Maybe you're waiting for it to be more solid. Definitely looks like it's going to be getting more solid. That solidity that you were waiting for, now it's here. So now it's kind of time to let the people know what's been going on, what you've been working on, what's been cooking. Because, you know, you can't hide forever. You cannot hide forever. Show the world the real you in deception, yeah. For some of you, you have, you're starting a new life with someone and you maybe have children with a previous partner. And it's kind of like, you know, letting this other person know, the person you co-parent with, that you will be moving forward with someone new. Maybe expecting, you know, a new baby with that person type of vibe. But it's okay. You got to do what you got to do. As you can see, the Queen of Wands, she's looking away from that Three of Swords. She's looking away from that Three of Swords. Let the chips fall where they may. It's time to create. It's time to live in your passion. It's time to be authentic. It's time to not give a... You know what I mean? Queen of Wands definitely doesn't give. One card for Capricorn, please. Could have fire in the charts. Scorpio as well. We also have Libra and Taurus with the Empress. But some of you are definitely elevating. This could be the one. Yeah, you've already met the romantic partner you seek. Let go of control issues as well as at the bottom of the deck. Can't control this. For some of you, you've had some sort of secret relationship and like you get knocked up and it's like, okay, well, you can't hide it now. You can't hide it now. Two cards. We have Anna, Grandmother of Jesus, seeding the light, laying the foundation, divine plan. So it's happening exactly how it should be. Don't be afraid of the new. Whoever it hurts, you got to live authentically to yourself. And play, have fun, celebrate, don't be so serious. It's time to loosen up, especially for you, Cappy. I know that's right. I know that's right. I know that's for you for sure. It's time to live your life for yourself. That's also what this Sagittarius energy is. This Knight of Wands energy is. It's time to loosen up. It's time to have more fun. It's time to live out loud. Stop hiding. Whoever hurts, it hurts. It's better you hurt them now than to hurt them later. Rip the Band-Aid off. Dream the world into being. Number 38, Lizard Spirit. Mm-hmm. Manifestations. And Rhino Spirit, overcome any obstacle. Number 5, energy of change. Taurus energy. So there is abundance on the other side of this authenticity. Major, major abundance. It's almost like it's unlocking. As soon as you speak your truth and stand in what you and own what it is you've been doing secretly here, things open up for you drastically. It's almost like it's not going to be as bad as you think it may be. It's not going to be as bad as you think it may be. It may shock some people for sure. But it may not be as bad as you think it may be. Okay? That is your reading, Capricorn. Really do hope it resonates with you. Thumbs me up. Don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you guys next week.